question for Dito Telcos Adel Tamano. If may implication ba sa commercial rollout nila sa March yung nakabinbin na franchise nila sa Senate? Confident ba sila that Congress will grant them a franchise before their rollout?
Thank you for that question. We are quite confident that Congress will see the wisdom of granting us a franchise extension before our commercial launch. We believe it will be most fair for Filipinos, especially the Filipino consumers, who will be buying our SIMs and will be investing in our service, to be assured that our franchise will continue and that we are that our business will be viable since it is based on that franchise. So we're very hopeful that will happen, and we're excited to, as we have been saying, to bring competition to the market starting March. And if I may just say, in regard to the question on coverage, we have a government commitment to have 84% coverage by our fifth year, so those underserved areas will be met. Allow us to say that that is our government commitment, but internally, we are going for 90% within 5 years. So those areas that have no mobile coverage, Dito will serve those areas. Thank you.
Opo, second question niyo pa, second question niya para pa rin po sa Dito. Update daw po sa ongoing plans, projects on ensuring that our national security and interest is protected even if 40% of the company is owned by Chinese state-run Chinatel.
If I can just say 3 points on that. First point, we are a Filipino company. It is run by Filipinos, and the officers are Filipino, the employees are Filipino. It is a Filipino country, and therefore we will never allow any espionage or anything that will be negative to our national security to happen due to our operations. Second, unlike other telco companies, we have been required by the DICT and the NTC to provide a cybersecurity plan. That was a requirement for our CPCN, and our cybersecurity plan is in place in order to protect our consumers and our network from cybersecurity problems, whether it be from other countries or whether it be from different groups. The third point is we are investing heavily in cybersecurity. Just for our security operations center, just this year, we have spent 1 billion pesos for that. And we'll continue to spend heavily because we know, and in fact, the NTC and the DICT were very wise. They knew that this would be an issue. And that is why they have made it a stringent requirement for us to provide our cybersecurity plans before our CPCN was granted. So I hope that answers your question.